think I wanna hear some horns. Well, the strangers in the room, you're no longer strangers, you're family now. So thank you for that. First of all, I want to thank everybody here for the show of support for Joan, my mom. If you're watching remotely, you guys right here, on behalf of me, Bill, and my family, we'd like to thank you for dedicating your time today to share Joan LeBeau Hayes' celebration of life with us and everyone present. Most, if not all of you, know who I am. But for those who don't, my name is Tony, and I'm Joan's son.
Hi, Tony.
Today, I'm not just a son. I'm not just a dad, an uncle, husband, cousin, or nephew, or a friend. Today, I'm your honorary celebration of life director. It's my hope today that you leave with a lasting memory of what I created and share to celebrate the life of my mom, Joan LeBeau Hayes. I want to start off with a round of thank yous. But first, I want to acknowledge my family and friends, my mom's friends and co-workers, and her husband, Bill, who's sitting over there, family, friends, and co-workers. Thank you for your warm condolences and support. I want to thank Bill's son, Keith, sitting over here to my left, for stepping up and providing the platform for this event to be live streamed by way of his production company, Sinister Productions. We give him a round of applause. I want to also thank my Prince Hall Masonic brethren from Massachusetts, C. Jackson and Bill Green, for their support and kind donations, as well as helping me with logistics and equipment for today's event. I want to acknowledge and thank two women that I've known for more than a half a century. So you know what that means, right? We old. My good friend and sister, Kim Wilson. Where are you?
She's working.
She stepped up and prepared the feast for today's celebration. And my extended family cousin, Lisa Cooper. She's remotely, so if you're watching, thank you. Our conversations during my time of grief have really helped me put this event in perspective. When your mother transitions, your rhythm in life gets adjusted. At times for me, it feels like free falling. I mean, it's a rush. When I look at everybody in this room, I know some of you know that I live for head rush. That triple digit speed, full throttle. Well, this is a different kind of ride. The guardrails on this journey of ours were provided by my wife, Jackie.
All right.
Where you are, there you go. She's been there to catch me when I'm falling, providing the support I need that helps me to adjust when my rhythm is off. I just want to say thank you. If I shed a tear, know that it's a tear of joy.
Right?
Because I don't have any regrets. I'm just glad to be in this moment here, right? And be amongst love and positive energy. I want to say thank you, and I appreciate your love, patience, and understanding through this phase in our lives. The next round of thanks go out to my lifelong support team that happens to be sitting right in front of me. You guys have been there for me since my first rotation around the sun. And I got the receipts. My Aunt Jackie and my sisters Rita and Leslie. Thank you. Little Rita, I like saying that. Hey, little Rita, you and Leslie stepped up, came through, and put that work in for me and Bill without hesitation. So thank you. And Auntie Jackie. Talking with you relaxes me. I've always been able to express myself with you. And I know I'm not the only nephew or niece or person that has been able to do that in their lives. Throughout my life, your support has always been consistent. You're a good listener. I know my mom's agreeing with my opinion right now. Your guidance has always brought value to my life, and I want to say thank you. Lastly, a few more thank yous. I'd like to thank Alex from Comfort Cremations for guiding me through this process so that I could share this moment with my mom one last time with family and friends. I also want to thank Pat and John O'Neill and Michelle. The cake out there, that beautiful cake with my mom's picture. And I say Pat like everybody here knows who she is, but Pat is my stepmom. My brother, who's already transitioned, mom. And I love you. And thank you. My daughter Ava will read my mom's obituary, followed by a prayer from Deacon John O'Neill. Words of memory will be shared by me, my wife Jackie, my daughter Ava, and my cousin Virginia Henry. Thank you. Ava?
Oh, I'm first.
Joan M. LeBeau Hayes, a beloved soul who graced this world with her kindness and warmth, transitioned peacefully at the UMass Memorial Medical Center in Worcester, Massachusetts. Joan was number seven of nine children born in Boston on June 28, 1941, to Thomas E. and Grace H. LeBeau of Boston, Mass. In her early years, Joan had a loving and devoted relationship with her father's mother, Mrs. Nellie LeBeau, before her transition. Beloved William Hayes and Joan were married in Westfield, Mass. At the residence of Charles and Jacqueline Howard on July 11, 2004. They remained married for 20 years. Like her parents, Joan was a true Bostonian raised in Boston's South End. In her youth, Joan's mother, Grace LeBeau, directed her to enroll in one of the most popular systems for teaching practical penmanship in America, the American Penman. Created by Austin Palmer in the late 19th century, Joan earned a Certificate of Proficiency while attending St. John's Catholic Grade School for the attainment of excellence in rapid, legible business writing. Joan attended and graduated from Roxbury Memorial High School for Girls in Boston, where she learned to type an average of 120 words per minute. This essential skill set became an important component of Joan's foundation for a life filled with learning and growth. Joan went on to start her career working for the recruitment and training program, and after several successful years, she transitioned over to the Massachusetts Bay Transit Authority, where she poured her hard work and dedication into the T's payroll system. For those who knew Joan will always remember her for her gentle and welcoming personality. She had a special gift for making everyone around her feel at ease, and she cherished every moment spent with her family and grandchildren. Joan's love for reading, travel, and being a devoted Nana illuminated the lives of all who were fortunate enough to know her. Beyond her professional accomplishments, Joan found pride in retiring after 20 years of service with the T and giving back by supporting St. Jude's, a testament to her generous spirit. In her leisure time, Joan found joy in receiving regular updates about her grandchildren's accomplishments, cheering on the Boston Celtics, listening to music, and exploring the world through her iPad. Joan was preceded in transitioning by her parents, her sister Norma LeBeau, and brothers Raymond LeBeau, Vernon LeBeau, John LeBeau, and Ralph LeBeau. Joan leaves behind a legacy of love and memories that will forever be treasured by her surviving family. Her loving husband, William Hayes, devoted son, Charles Howard, caring sister, Rita Lopes, beloved sister, Jackie LeBeau, dear brother, Lawrence LeBeau, cherished daughter-in-law, Jacqueline Howard, and her adoring grandchildren, Jonas Kefalis, Tyreek Hayes, and Terrell Hayes. Joan also leaves a host of loving nieces and nephews. While our hearts are heavy with grief at the loss of Joan from this world, we find solace in knowing that she has left behind a lasting imprint of kindness and love on all those who had the privilege of knowing her. May she rest in peace, knowing she was loved beyond measure.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And my name is Deacon John E. O'Neill, and my home church is People's Baptist Church, and our pastor is Reverend Wesley A. Roberts. Joan's son, Tony, is an important part of my family, and he's asked me to offer this prayer in loving memory of his mother, Joan Hayes, LeBeau Hayes. Oh, man. What a turnout. Today we thank you, Lord, for Joan's life and all the years she shared with us. We lift her to you in honor of the good we saw in her and the love we felt from her. Please give Joan's family and friends the strength to leave her in your care in the knowledge of eternal life through Jesus Christ. We must always remember the ones we love. Never go away. They walk beside us, even on this day. Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life she lived when she was strong. It's just a wonderful, wonderful time, and I thank Tony so much for asking me to do this. Dear God, I want to leave this with you. Dear God, bless us, and as you bless us, help us to be a blessing to someone else. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Hungry, moving right along here. All right, so where do I begin? From the beginning. That's the correct answer. So we're going to do it from the beginning. On June 28, 1941, my grandparents, Thomas and Grace LeBeau, gave birth to a beautiful baby girl. As a result of this event, I stand here before my family and friends to celebrate Joan LeBeau Hayes' wonderful, extraordinary life. Now, I'm sure the first 24 years of my mom's life were filled with exciting moments that consisted of triumphs, challenges, and struggles. But I think the years she accumulated after were much more memorable, and I say that selfishly. When I reflect back to the past memories, I am reminded of just how strong a woman my mom was. At times, I felt like we were surrounded by the worst Roxbury had to offer. My mom never showed fear. She raised me from a boy to a young man while maintaining a nurturing, loving environment in our home. That had to be the ultimate test for a mother. To stand by her son during a multitude of situations, she passed with flying colors. To this day, my childhood friends, and a few of them are here, and my childhood friends that are still alive, reminisce on her firm and direct approach to correct situations that were out of order. Okay. To correct us when we were out of order. God knows we had our moments, but my mom never turned her back on me. Her actions of support were always bold and powerful. She governed our relationship with love, comfort, and an iron fist. During the late 80s, when the family was in need of leadership during times of sorrow, my mom stepped right up with her siblings and handled the business. The Bible states, man that is born of a woman is but a few days, and his life is full of trouble. Unbelievably, when God decided to take the man you loved on his true Masonic journey, you unknowingly prepared him for his trip to that undiscovered country from whose born no traveler returns. Rest in power, Aubrey Rose. Over time, most would say that you were a truly blessed woman, and I would agree. Because God has allowed me to share 58 of your 82 rotations around the sun. That's a great number. Doing the math, that comes out to roughly 70%. That's a big number too. To put that in perspective, I got to share 70% of my mother's existence in life. Shoot, imagine if you got a 70% pay raise.
Right?
Or imagine you got 70% off your next car purchase. Sounds crazy, right? God is good. I want to take this time to thank you for all that you have done in your life, Mom, your grandkids' lives, and mine. I am forever grateful. We know that in life there are no guarantees. Nobody in this room is promised tomorrow. Let that sink in. God's gifts don't come with guarantees, but they do come with guidance. My mom's life is a testament to his guidance and his gifts. My mother cared, she loved, she supported, and she led by providing a rock-stable lifestyle for me to grow, flourish, and learn how to move and survive. To quote a good friend of mine who's watching remotely, your mother loved you to the moon and back. My mom extended that same raw, uncut love to my wife and my kids. At the end of every phone call, she would say, "Hug my family for me."
He got you.
And tell them that I love them. No cap. For those of you that knew Joan, you also knew that her will was as strong as the Incredible Hulk. Her strength came from her uncut determination, will, and persistency. Towards the end of her life's journey, she was determined to make her own decisions. As she was 45 years ago, so she was determined to make her own decisions as she was 45 years ago. And for the record, right, my mom wasn't one to be rolled over. She stood tall, right? You had to earn her respect. She could sense weakness. And if you presented as weak, she would treat you as such, but with love and kindness in a stern and firm way. She stood tall on her principles with the same uncut will and persistency that I just mentioned. In her last days, my mother's personality reminded me of a Maya Angelou quote. "I can be changed by what happens to me, but I refuse to be reduced by it." Powerful. My mother has tradition like her parents, her five siblings, and life partner. In closing, I want to read aloud the poem I feel represents her the best. God saw you getting tired. God saw you getting tired and the cure was not to be, so he put his arms around you and whispered, "Come to me." With tearful eyes, we watched you and saw you pass away. And although we love you dearly, we could not make you stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hard-working hands at rest. God broke our hearts to prove to us he only takes the best. Rest in beauty, Joan LeBeau Hayes, my mom.
Amen.
Hello, everyone. So I'm Jackie Howard, the, I would almost say in her words, famous daughter-in-law.
Yeah.
In that, the usual daughter-in-law relationship. This is a very loving relationship that we had. And, you know, we would talk also, especially on my commutes back from work, just to check on each other, see how we're doing. And something you might all know is that she loved butterflies, right? That was like her motif. She loved butterflies. So for each letter in the word butterfly, the following words remind me of Joan. B for beautiful, U for unforgettable, T for tenacious, T for trustworthy, E for earnest, R for resolute, F for fabulous, L for loyal, and Y, young at heart. I love you, Joan LeBeau, and I will sincerely miss you.
I think we can all agree this is a lot. I wrote a speech. You would think that, knowing me, if those who do know me, I would be prepared and wrote it, you know, weeks ago, but in all honesty, I wrote it on the way here, but it's all honest. It goes without saying that everyone here knows my Nana, and that her legacy is what currently lights up this room. Her legacy is what made my father, and his legacy is what made me. Sorry. My Nana was a multifaceted woman, but to me, she was the sweetest and strongest guardian I could ask for. Ever since I was a little girl, she always told me that her biggest wish in life was to one day be a Nana. I have lived my life knowing she's proud of me. From my smaller accomplishments, like learning how to do a cartwheel, to bigger ones, such as advancing my education and learning Spanish while abroad in Europe. As she was one of my biggest supporters, it's hard to know that from now on there will be no more calls from her on Christmas Day, or my birthday, or whenever she wishes to say hello. Despite this heartbreak, I am fully content with all the 17 years I had with my Nana. As I begin my personal chapter of adulthood, finding out who I am, what I love, and who I love, I believe that my Nana is still with me. She may no longer be on this earth in her physical form, but in every butterfly I see from now on, I'll know she's there. With the time I still have, I hope to continue to make Nana proud in my academics, in my athletics, and in my adventures. Throughout this day, I encourage everyone to think about what my Nana's legacy meant to you, whether she was a mother, an aunt, a sister, or a friend, and know that in her legacy, we continue to shape our own. Thank you.
Okay, all of a sudden I feel hot. You know, I probably sound nervous, but that's okay. Try it, Jules. I know you because of Auntie Joan. But, you know, I've been called
crazy quite a bit through my life, matter of fact. I won't mention any family members' names, but my brother Bob just called me crazy yesterday. And you know, with people that I've worked with, you know, I don't know what it is. Am I too loud in here? But I realized, hello?
Who are you?
Who am I? Oh, okay. Virginia Henry. I'm Rita Lopes' daughter. Oh my gosh, how come I didn't say that? Everybody knew. Yeah, I'm the oldest, and Tony's cousin, and all that. But I realized that I am crazy. Because who in the world would get up to do public speaking? This ain't no joke. Okay? Get a little nervous and everything, but that lady right there, when the opportunity came, I said, I gotta say something. I don't know what I'm gonna say. I was thinking of writing something down, but I'm like, you know what? It still hasn't set in. It hasn't set in yet. Her spirit is so alive. I left home when I was about 18. It was about 10 years ago. And, I think on one hand, I can tell you that I saw Auntie Joan on one hand less than that amount of times in person. But the phone calls, OMG, the phone calls were amazing. She made me feel so, so special. She poured out the love on the phone. Matter of fact, I had to, you know, talk to her when nobody was home, because anytime I get on the phone, my husband thinks it's an invitation for him to talk. You know, so I'm like, okay, I gotta wait till everybody's gone, because I wanted to give her that time to talk. I loved listening to Auntie Joan talk. She has some stories to tell. And I recently, you know, I've seen the love, I have felt the love, but then I realized recently, on the other end of the spectrum, that there was the Joan that I didn't really see much of as far as the toughness and stuff. Probably because, well, I was always nice to her, you know, so she was cool with that. But Tony has been sharing some stories with me the last few weeks and stuff, and tell me about how tough she was, like he expressed, growing up. I'm like, whoa. So that's the type of person who raises a cop. I always wondered what would make somebody want to be a cop. But then I'm like, oh, okay. You got a mother who takes no crap. You see that your whole life. And you grow up and they don't take no crap. And you want to help your community. Okay? And it made sense. And I'm like, okay, so that's why some cops are raised. This was a tough lady to raise a cop. I love her so much. But she made me feel so special. And then, you know, I thought it was just me. But then I read all the condolences. And I think everybody felt that from her. Such a loving, loving human being. And Jackie, you said that it was just a typical relationship, mother-in-law, daughter. No, it was more than that. Oh, she loves you. She idolized you so much. You were such a special part of her life. She loves some Jackie. And Ava, Jonas, no. You know, and I don't know if it's going to take you all becoming grandparents to know what it's like to be a Nana. My mouth is getting dry. Can I get some water?
Can I?
She is crazy. But Ava, thanks to Auntie Joan, you know, Facebook, I've been able to watch you grow up. but I never thought you was this gorgeous. Oh my gosh, look at you. And Jonas, I met you through Facebook. She loved y'all. You know, she shared pictures and she would talk on the telephone about, I really feel like I know y'all because of our conversations. She loved being a nana. So thank you for giving her that opportunity to be a nana. Because I'm a nana. I get 8 grandchildren. I tell you, I wouldn't change it for the world. So when we talk on the phone, we can relate. We can relate. I know what it feels like to be a nana. She adores you all so much. There's no, you know, I learned a new word the other day, ineffable. Anybody know that? You know, when you don't have the words to, you know, express. That's what it's like trying to express this beautiful being up here, this beautiful spirit. It's just really no words. You got to feel it, you know, you got to feel it. And I felt it every single time I talked with her. And before you get off the phone, Virginia, make sure you hug your husband. Make sure you hug all them grandkids. She never got off the phone without saying that. Make sure you hug all them grandkids. OMG. And those of us who are married know that it can be kind of rough sometimes. But Bill, Auntie Joan made it sound like it was a piece of cake for you. You were her world. I don't know you personally, but I feel like I do. She loved some Bill. You know, she just adored everybody. And you know, I grew up believing in God. I don't ever remember a moment where I didn't believe in God, okay? And something tells me that the spirit just lives on. You know, she may be gone physically, but oh my God, I feel her more up in me than ever before. She's with us now. You know, she's in our hearts now. We can have conversations all the time. I don't have to wait for the phone call. I can talk to her right now. She's here with us. You know, her spirit lives on. You know, so I think that's all I have to say. It's just really kind of no words to express the overwhelming love I have for my auntie. Ain't she cute? Oh my goodness. Well, thank y'all. Thank you for being down here.
We go along with that, but you're not crazy.
She is crazy.
Yes, I don't.
She is.
No, she's crazy. So I put a video together that I think reflects my mother's existence the past 82 years. I'm going to play it and make sure that you have tissues available because some of you will be touched. And then after that, we will eat.
Do 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 do. right, so pay attention to the car, right? So this is the G-force. Tell me what you think.
Thank you. I'm gonna go get some I never knew I'd be so secure. Thank you. Look at the cigarette machine.
Yeah.
to say.
She's listening.
Words sometimes get in the way.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I feel.
I just want to show feelings for you.
So easily mistreated, every decision.
So now brings the best part of today's event. Blessing the food so we can eat.
Okay.
All right?
Hello. Hi. Giving honor to God and all you beautiful people here today. I'm going to be short because that food smells so good. But what I really want to say is that I'm so grateful to be here with this family. My mom's always said that family that prays together stays together. And Tony has shown the love that his mother, Miss Joan, has shown in this world. If I can tell you that I've never, ever been to something of this caliber in my life that I enjoyed so much that Tony has put together. I salute you, I salute him and his family, and all I want to say, as I say this prayer, can we please rise and give this family a round of applause? I'm going to give this out the way. All the brothers and sisters, all the brothers, remove your hats, please, and bow your heads. Father God, give us this day. Father God, keep your hand on this family. Father God, Joan is in this room today putting spirit to all of our soul. Father God, I want to just thank you. I don't want to ask you for nothing. I just want to thank you what you've done for us. I want to thank you for having Joan put this spirit in all of us today and keep us strong. If God, my child, or anyone's child, can be the child that Tony has been in this world, we will all be great. Father God, bless the food, bless the people who prepared this food, to serving this food, to giving us this food. In your name's sake, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, if I can just ask before we go out, hold up, everybody. Hold up. William Hayes. I'd like your table to go up first.
Thank you. Thank you for watching.
And then after that, you guys can just fall in respectfully, orderly.
You want to look right into the camera and just thank people for watching. You can speak right into the mic.
I want to take this also, this time also, and thank everybody that have taken their day and their time and dedicated to being part of this event. We thank you for your support. God bless you.
right off and you're nowhere. You didn't know.